What is going on, guys? It is me, back for another YouTube video, and today I'm going to talk about something that I really, really love, and that is the Halo universe. As you guys know, Halo 5 is about 3 weeks away from launching, and I cannot be more excited about this. So today, I'm going to be playing some Halo Master Chief Collection. We're going to go ahead and just play some H2A Anniversary, and see where that goes. But today, we're talking about... I'm about to sneeze, but I don't feel it yet. I hate that feeling. But well, I have some interesting theories. As you guys know, Hump the Truth is back. And if you don't know what Hump the Truth is, it is a documentary type. It's an audio. Basically, audio files are released every single week on the Tumblr page of HumpTheTruthTumblr.com. And I'm extremely excited about this. I love it. The thing that I love about the Hunt the Truth series is the reason it's better than any other series, live action series, anything like that, is because of its, it picks up quick. Like, it's basically like a mini series and it picks up very quick. Unlike all the others where it does it in least like, 2 hour movie long things, 2 hour, like 2 hours, and it's slow, and then it, what do you know, it's over, and went right when it started to actually get good. So, with this, I wanted to talk about the Hunt the Truth series, what I think will happen, and also, the day after I'm recording this, last night during the Green Bay Packers versus the Kansas City Chiefs football game, there was a Halo 5 commercial. And what is on this Halo 5 commercial, you ask? Well, I'm glad you asked. What is in it is a... They show Master Chief dying and Oni giving off saying that the Master Chief has passed away. And I wanted to give maybe a couple theories on that as well. So let's go ahead and hit right into the commercial. I'm gonna tell you guys like it is. I can't show you the.
This takes longer than I remember.
The commercial because of copyright laws. I will get flagged and you guys won't be able to see the video. I'm going to put a link down to the commercial in the description as well as Hunt the Truth. Alright, so now let's get to the commercial. In the commercial, they show Chief dying in battle. Here's the thing though. I don't think that's Chief.
Oh, we're on the opposite team.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah.
I don't think Chief is dead. You might not be able to hear those people talking. That's why I kind of froze up. I don't think that is Chief. I think this is Oni's way of getting... People are going to be wondering how come Chief isn't saving the day, what was up with Oni and all that. And I think that was Oni's way of getting rid of him, saying that he has died in combat. So I don't think that was Chief actually dying. I think that's Oni send off to that way Chief... They don't know where Chief is because of Chief going AWOL. Alright, now we get into Hunt the Truth. But yes, the commercial, because I don't think, you see, as also in, actually in the commercial, of people being worried. So people have not lost faith in Chief. Oni's only way to get rid of them is basic. It must have been done so that way Chief, when shit's going down, people aren't looking for Chief to come in and save the day. So, I think that is why that commercial was aired. Now, I'm going into a Hunt the Truth. Now, keep in mind, guys, this is all theories of mine, and this is me nerding out, because Halo 3 was my all-time favorite video game ever. I loved it to death. Halo 3, I have so many couch co-op memories. I just have massive, great memories of Halo 3. Yeah. Lost the lead. And then, yeah, so now we're gonna go move into Hunt the Truth. I do enjoy this Halo. Halo 2 Anniversary was great, but, alright. So, now we can talk about H2, my theories, all that good jazz. I suck. Okay, now on to Hunt the Truth. Alright, so as you guys know, we are now in Season 2 of Hunt the Truth. And what happened in the previous season, if you guys don't want spoilers, go away now. If you guys just want to hear my theories, yeah, just continue watching the video. So, in last episode, Benjamin Giroux was going to expose Oni for all the shit they have done. Including, flaming Chief for things he didn't do, such as the Oni, when a Chief and possibly, it looked like to where Chief shot innocents, but he didn't. He was trying to save them, but they used some camera work to make it look like he killed them, but it was really the elites. And Benjamin Giroux was going to expose them once and for all as, like, bastards. Alright, so, let's go ahead and move into it. And people were framed. So, Oni, then, right when Benjamin Giroux was going on national television to frame these people, they made a huge revelation of, they showed the camera angles that Ben had found and was showing that Chief was a good citizen and all that good jazz, and they were A-okay with Chief again. So that, unfortunately, was going to discredit Mr. Giroux. And so Benjamin Giroux keeps making acquisitions that he has no backup now because of what Oni just did. And people were asking, well, how did this stuff happen? All this good jazz is because he was working with a great worker. He was going with, like, basically a conspiracy theorist, Pharaoh. And Pharaoh, unfortunately, is in, now we know in this episode, a double agent for the government to keep them having hope. And that's very interesting. It's very cool, almost like a 1984, like, just to give these people some hope of what has happened. So, interesting. So, now we know that Pharaoh sold him out. That was in the prologue, you kind of get that Pharaoh sold him out, and then we get, Pharaoh giving another, like, speech, and then in the next episode, we also find what her real name is. Her real name is Maya. So Maya is a agent for Oni, and Oni now, here's the thing, though, about this, is that where does Petra come in? I'm very interested to see. Yeah, I'm very interested because in the season finale, the last lines were, and that was the last time I ever saw Benjamin Giroux, and Petra was going to continue the stories for Mr. Giroux. She was going to continue to hunt the truth. So, with that being said, there's no sign of Petra. So, I don't know if they just pulled an audible and said, screw it. I don't know. So we are right now with Maya, aka Pharaoh. I'm A-okay with that. I didn't know how I would like it, but it has been doing very well. I've been enjoying it almost as much as when Benjamin Jarrell was doing the Hunt for Truth. And Benjamin Jarrell is, he's such a great character in the universe that they have made with this Hunt for Truth series. It's amazing. And I keep doing, like, backstories and all that, but I'll get to the theory eventually. So, Maya is, you see, going into Oni headquarters, and she sees Ben. So, we know Ben is alive. We know Ben is okay, but not mentally. He is unstable. And they have been working with him to get him better. And Ben says he knows what he did was wrong, and Oni's kind of manipulating his mind. So, yeah. They've been manipulating his mind to think of, that what he was doing was wrong. And so he says, I'm ready to apologize. And he was going to give a big speech, and he was going to even mention Pharaoh, how Pharaoh was helping him. And, she said, no, don't do that. Because then that would break her cover. And people would not, be very happy. Double kill from the grave. A-okay by me. And people would stop following her. So that would break cover, and, it is later after this conversation that they were having of Maya seeing Ben in the headquarters that it was revealed to Ben that, she has, betrayed Ben and told Oni of what he was about to do on national television, releasing the evidence and all of that. So, we then later get into the details of and then Ben says he trusted her and all that, and then and basically Ben would then later get knocked out by Gaz. And they get into an argument with Maya gets into an argument with his taker, the one that has been giving him, that's been trying to treat Ben and all that. And he's saying that I have had I've been okay with him until you showed up, you're the one to blame and all that. So, alright, now that I'm up to date, if you guys enjoy this type of stuff, of me recapping and then giving maybe some theories of what could go, I'm definitely down to do that. Kind of like Green Skull from Ready Up Live, all that. So yeah, I'm thinking of doing that as well on every Friday night when it's released, I'm pretty sure, of doing a new recap of Hunt the Truth. And I can just be sitting here playing Halo, all that good jazz. So, now we're gonna get into my theories. The whole reason I wanted to do this video. So the theories I have are, now keep in mind they're all just theories, and I don't want anyone to get their hopes up thinking I have something extra or anything. Here's what I think. I think by the end of season 2 of Hunt the Truth, there are gonna be things that are going to happen. One of them being Maya's death. I'm pretty sure Maya will die. And here is another, like I said, theory of mine, that I think that Blue Team is going to save Ben Jarrell. And the reason I think this is because of the following. Now, do you guys remember the Halo commercials that originally aired? This was during The Walking Dead. They had two commercials of Locke's point of view and Chief's point of view. One of them being Chief's, as you guys know, Chief's point of view. And in this video, he says, was it worth it? Was it worth all the things that you've done? The lies, the breaking, breaking the military, all that, was it worth it? And here's my thing. I don't think that Chief actually was talking to Locke in that commercial up until he said, "My mission is just beginning, Agent Locke. Yours is ending." I don't think he was talking to Spartan Locke until he says that. All the things of him, like, there are people that still believe in Chief after maybe only continuing to frame him of all the things he's done. That Oni could have been blaming, and I'm not saying that for anything. All we know is that Oni doesn't like Chief, and maybe that through AWOL or anything. We know, besides maybe fans liking him, Oni, the UNSC, doesn't want to do anything with the Master Chief. So, then what they will end up doing is, I think that through all this, through the framing, that Master Chief would have saw Ben trying to defend his name. And through Oni capturing him, I think that how Maya will end up dying is trying to defend the base, as Blue Team, including the Master Chief, will be breaking Oni in to save Ben from Oni's clutches, whatever you want to call it.
Game over.
Damn, we lost. But I think it's going to end up happening. The reason I do think this is because of the lines he said. Actually, I have them up here on my computer. Let me get to them. Actually, it's on my phone, but... nope. But yes, the reason I think this is... He says the following. "Is this what you wanted? Is this what you were looking for? Was everything you compromised, everything you've done, worth it?" And then he sees Spartan Locke. So I think that until then he was talking to himself, and I'm saying everything he was doing was even killing Oni, UNSC, to get Benjamin Giroux out, and was it worth it all to do what? I'm simply thinking that his mission in Halo 5 is probably to save Cortana. And even in Locke's commercial, he says, "Oh, how the mighty has fallen," basically. That you are our savior and not a betrayer. Betrayer? Why? Maybe because of those shootings that were falsely accused on Chief? Or just maybe of him breaking into a UNSC Oni base to get Benjamin Giroux, one of the only people that were willing to think the Chief was innocent.
Don't talk back. Na-na-na-na-na-na-na.
So that's why I think it. Tell me what your guys' theories are.
Ooh, one playoff.
Yeah.
Whoa.
So, it's interesting.
No. No, I don't want the SMGs. No. No.
Yeah. I that's my theory, guys, is that Ben is going to get out of Oni alive because of Blue Team and the Chief coming in to save the day.
I forgot we have SMGs in the show.
What is this fucking bullshit?
Whoever is doing Hunt the Truth, I want to commend you on doing a fantastic job of just amazing work all around. I'm interested to continue doing this, guys. I love Hunt the Truth and I love Halo, and once Halo 5 comes out, I'm going to be doing so much, much, much more Halo 5 Guardians campaign gameplays, everything, multiplayer. Halo 5 is my most anticipated game this year, more than Fallout 4, all of that good jazz. Although there are a lot of good games,
this is no fear,
coming out, I cannot wait for this one in particular. So yeah, guys, if you have a theory of the in Hunt the Truth that you guys would like to give me, leave it down in the comments below. Tell me what you guys would like to see, all of that good jazz. We're gonna go ahead and get into this one. I'm gonna look, you guys can watch it and we can commentate it. Just tell me what you guys think down in the comments below.
Lost the lead.
I'm always interested in new theories, guys, and Hunt the Truth is beyond amazing. So, like I said, I think Maya will be dead by the end of Season 2, and will be, she will either die by trying to defend Ben from Blue Team, one of the only people still that had faith in the Master Chief through the times.
I probably thought you weren't gonna die today. Surprise!
Alright, I'm getting focused in now. Hold on. Give me the sniper rifle. I cannot aim. Got it! Oh my god, I cannot aim for shit. Can I aim? No, I cannot.
It's a bomb!
I'm in the zone, like AutoZone.
Why am I still alive?
No! I was gonna get that kill. Alright, they're moving. Oh wow, they're trying to rotate back to the AR tower. No!
Bullshit!
That's my strategy. Whenever you're about to die, do the best in your ability to bring them down with you. Alright, we're gonna get the snipers. Hopefully snipers respawn, but yeah. If you guys have any questions on the theory, you guys are more than welcome to comment down below and see what you think. Ooh, that was a good stick. But, what are your theories on Hunt the Truth? Do you think Maya will live? When do you think Petra is going to get involved? Because I don't see how they're going to fit it in, but it's definitely going to happen, I think. I just don't know where. Oh, wow, I just got killed, but Can he? No, he can't. Bob the Builder, can we fix it? Bob the Builder, no, they can't. Eat it.
Fucking bullshit out of the game.
That guy's an angry individual.
Yeah, we're gonna lose this shit.
Sniper. Scoot Muckin. Bob Muckin.
Can't hit him, but he could hit me.
Tell me if you guys are also excited about Halo 5 as much as I am. I'm buying basically everything. Yes, a battle rifle, thank you. Even though it's basically useless. I won't get this, I guess. Aw, crap, shoddy.
This is bullshit.
5 minutes remain.
Fucking camping, faggot.
Come back, kid.
Fucking was camp.
Not my day.
Game over.
But yes, guys, that's gonna be the end for this one. Like I said, my theory is that Maya will be dead and Blue Team will rescue Ben out of the clutches of Oni. Tell me what your guys' theories are down in the comments below. I'm more than happy to read them and all that good jazz. I'm looking forward to reading them. If you guys are excited about Halo, tell me what you're most excited. Halo 5 multiplayer mode down in the comments below. Mine will be Breakout. I love the idea of just that competitive, really competitive edge, and I'm really excited for it. I'm really excited for Halo, guys. Hopefully you are too. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. I think we're gonna continue this in a series. We're gonna do a weekly update on Hunt the Truth and what's happening and what my thoughts are on it. Like I said, I think Hunt the Truth is the best series out on there, and I'm going to put the link for the Halo 5 commercial down in the comments below, in the description down below, and for Hunt the Truth website. Like I said, tell me what you guys think of your theories and all that good jazz in the comments below as well. I know I've been delaying this outro quite a bit, but hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Hit that like button, it helps a lot, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace out.